I love to interview Stephen, and the reason that I do is because he understands how vast the invisible world is. I mean, you've had some experiences that you don't talk a lot about, but you've had some experiences in the supernatural realm, in the invisible world, where you've literally gone to great men or women of God that are teachers, and they've taught you. Explain.
You're right, Sid. The spirit realm is much like the Pacific Ocean, has tremendous depth. Much of it is unexplored. And we're going to venture further out into the spirit and make greater discoveries. But there are those times when the Spirit of God can catch a person up into the realm of the spirit. And by the grace of God, there could even could be a visitation from the Lord. There could be communication with the angelic realm. And sometimes there's even communication with the redeemed saints. We see that in Hebrews chapter 12, where the writer of Hebrews told us that we have come to Mount Zion. We're not going to Mount Zion. He said, you've come to Mount Zion to a company of innumerable angels, angels beyond number, and also to the spirits of just men made perfect.
Tell me one experience you had where you were taught things or received something from someone in the spirit realm.
Well, one time the Lord caught me up into the heavenly realm, and I met William Seymour, and I was allowed to talk with him. And William Seymour who gave me a...
Now, for those that aren't familiar with William Seymour, he was a one-eyed black man that God picked to lead what has since been called the Pentecostal Revival. So you actually met him?
Yes.
Did he have one eye when you saw him?
No, his eye was completely healed. He was a big black brother, big shoulders, and at first I didn't know who he was, but he was dressed very, very nice, but a man of... He looked like a prince, and said he began to give me a charge. He said, you must pray for the young children, particularly the children that suffer from Down syndrome, mental retardation. He said, the Lord will heal these children. And he gave me some further instruction about praying for the sick and to minister to the sick in faith, expecting God to heal those that are prayed for. And we have been seeing miracles take place along this line.
Well, tell me about one child you prayed for.
Well, it's interesting because many times we have parents fly into our meetings from out of state or from long distances, bringing children into the meetings with great need. And I was in a meeting recently in Southern California, and somebody flew in from Colorado bringing their child that was suffering from autism. And it was amazing that that parent, the husband and the wife, had so many obstacles and difficulties to overcome. The enemy was really trying to keep them from getting into those meetings. But they finally made it. They got up there, and I was able to pray for the child. And an angel of the Lord, Sid, came into the meeting. And myself and several other people saw this angel came into the meeting and blew a mist over that young child. And immediately, we couldn't tell any difference, but the parents, I'm getting responses back from parents that things, they're seeing slow progress of mental alertness and things the children used to not be able to do, those things are beginning to happen now.
Just a curiosity question. Why did you see William Seymour? Why did he tell you to pray for children? Well, what's the reason behind this?
Well, you know, if you study about Azusa Street and that great move of the Spirit that happened there in that area of Los Angeles, California, right around the turn of the century, the early 1900s, a great move of God broke out. And there were many children involved in those meetings. A lot of people can identify certain ministers as being involved with those meetings and great miracles happening. But the children were even praying for people and miracles were taking place. And the Shekinah glory that dwelt in that old horse stable where they had the meetings, that was so thick that the children could actually play hide and go seek in the glory. They could dip down into it, and you couldn't see a person when you got into it.
You know, I look so forward to the day that little children are going to be walking up to people that are blind and praying for them, and they're getting their sight, or cancer, and the cancer is going. I mean, you have to have the faith like a little child, so it comes easy for a little child.
That's right, and William Seymour also prophesied right around 1910 that 100 years from that time, America would be visited again with a great outpouring of God's Spirit. It's about the break. And we're already moving in these things. It's going to sweep over the church.
That's why you wrote your new book, Standing on the Shoulders of Giants, because he talks about the same presence for miracles that, or for other supernatural phenomena that were on many old-timers, it's coming back now.